Let's train your ear in French with pop culture. I'm going to show you a real trailer for a 2007 French movie. Then we're going to break it down together to identify French sentence templates that you can use to join in a French conversation. But first, what can you understand from this trailer?
Il y a quelques jours, la destinée m'a fait croiser le chemin de celle que vous allez voir maintenant. Vous allez la voir telle qu'elle m'est apparue.
Allez, venez.
C'est une grande artiste.
Parce que j'ai mis des talons.
Elle est étourdissante.
La scène, c'est un tout. T'as des mains merveilleuses. Certain.
Brigitte. Sors. Je suis ta mère.
Qui n'ont pas eu de chance.
Allez, l'amour. Chante-nous un truc.
Vous ne m'avez jamais.
On peut penser à un moineau, un piaf, un môme piaf.
T'es mon champion. Je veux que tu sois à moi pour la vie.
Tu as l'air d'une fée.
Non.
Je dois chanter, Louis, j'ai pas le choix.
C'est une suicide.
Je ne regrette rien.
Votre voix est comme l'âme de Paris.
Il est bien.
Il faut que tu sois courageuse, Edith. L'avion s'est écrasé.
Car ma vie, aujourd'hui, ça commence avec moi.
So this was une bande annonce. Une bande annonce, a trailer for the 2007 French movie La Môme, also known as, yes, La Vie en Rose. In its international release, this is the name they picked, it was directed by Olivier Dahan. This movie is a biopic of super famous French singer Edith Piaf. La Môme was her nickname. It is old-fashioned slang for the kid, la môme. Now, the trailer starts with a showman's speech introducing the young singer. Listen.
Il y a quelques jours, la destinée m'a fait croiser le chemin de celle que vous allez voir maintenant. Vous allez la voir telle qu'elle m'est apparue.
Il y a quelques jours, la destinée m'a fait croiser le chemin de celle que vous allez voir maintenant. A few days ago, destiny made me cross the path of the woman you're going to see now. Vous allez la voir telle qu'elle m'est apparue. You're going to see her as she appeared to me. This is formal French, using pompous grammar and showmanship. It is an introduction speech, after all. It is not an everyday conversation that you and I can have in French. But there's an interesting construction here. Vous allez la voir. You're going to see her. Vous allez la voir. Repeat after me. Vous allez la voir. Again. Vous allez la voir. This is le futur proche. Le futur proche. It's the near future where we use aller and the infinitive of the verb. You can tweak this template to use it and to understand it in everyday spoken French conversations. You know, without spending these 30 seconds trying to translate the sentence in your head from French to English and then trying to figure out something to say after. The next sequence is...
C'est une grande artiste.
Parce que j'ai mis des talons.
C'est une grande artiste. She is a great artist. And then she answers... Parce que j'ai mis des talons. Parce que j'ai mis des talons. Because I put on some heels. Well, that's a funny joke because of French grammar. When a French adjective has two places where it can be, when it is put after the noun, it means a literal meaning. And if you put it before, it is more of a metaphorical meaning. Here, c'est une grande artiste means she's a great artist. But c'est une artiste grande means she's very tall. She's a tall artist. Here, Edith is too young and naive to understand that they're seeing her as a great artist and not just talking about her height. But the compliments keep coming and more stuff happens.
Elle est étourdissante.
La scène, c'est un tout.
T'as des mains merveilleuses.
Certain.
Edith, sors.
Je suis ta mère.
Here, trouble appears for young Edith because she has now a complicated relationship with her mother. She uses the imperative sort, get out. It is very short and powerful. You could also use va-t'en, go away, va-t'en. Your turn now, repeat after me. Sors, va-t'en. Again, sors, va-t'en. And here's another line that you can practice.
Allez la môme, chante-nous un truc.
Allez la môme, come on the kid. Allez la môme. Here you can see a great way to use allez for an encouragement in everyday spoken French. Then we have chante-nous un truc. Sing us something. Chante-nous un truc. Here you have an imperative and a very classic piece of French slang for un truc. Un truc is a thingy or stuff. Un truc. Can you repeat it and fix it in your brain? Allez la môme, chante-nous un truc. Repeat after me. Allez la môme, chante-nous un truc. Now, by the way, where does her nickname comes from? The trailer gives us a clue.
Ça me fait penser à un moineau, un piaf. La môme piaf.
We hear Edith's manager say, elle me fait penser à un moineau. She reminds me of a sparrow. Elle me fait penser à un moineau, un piaf. Un piaf is slang for a bird, un piaf. So this is why we have both nicknames for Edith Piaf. La môme and piaf. Piaf, which will become her stage name. The last third of the trailer gives us a glimpse into her tragic love life.
T'es mon champion. Je veux que tu sois à moi pour la vie.
Tu as l'air d'une fée.
And here we have three templates for everyday French sentences. T'es mon champion. You are my champion. T'es mon champion. Here, tu es. You already know that, it means you are, but in everyday spoken French, we eat letters, we speak very fast, so tu es becomes t'es, t'es, t'es mon champion. Then we have je veux que tu sois à moi pour la vie, I want you to be mine for life, je veux que tu sois à moi pour la vie. Here what you can learn from this is the structure, je veux que tu sois is je veux que plus subjunctive. I want something to happen. I need something. It's a desire. Je veux que plus subjunctive. For example, if you learn this structure and you hear je veux que tu sois à l'heure. Je veux que tu sois à l'heure in everyday spoken French. You know it will mean I want you to be on time. Finally, tu as l'air d'une fée. You look like a fairy. Tu as l'air d'une fée. This is a great use of avoir l'air, to look like. Avoir l'air in French. You'll learn more about this structure later, but first let's look at the last lines of the trailer.
Non,
je dois chanter, Louis, j'ai pas le choix.
C'est du suicide.
Non, je ne regrette rien.
Votre voix est comme l'âme de Paris.
Il est bien.
Sois courageuse, Edith. L'avion s'est écrasé.
Car ma vie,
here, life gets very dark for Edith, but it gives you very good sentence templates that you can use in French conversations. Repeat after me. Qu'est-ce qu'il se passe? Again. Qu'est-ce qu'il se passe? Now, je n'ai pas le choix, or j'ai pas le choix. J'ai pas le choix. And at last, il faut que tu sois courageuse. Again, il faut que tu sois courageuse. Repeating all the sentences in this video will help you understand what is going on in a French conversation. It's like a trick to ease your comprehension of everyday spoken French, which is fast. And it works even better if you're confident in what is going on in these sentences. This is why I prepared a special playlist for you where we dive deeper into the grammar, the culture, and the everyday French in these sentences that we saw today. Start with a breakdown of Edith Piaf's life and most famous love song. Then dive into le futur proche with aller and the infinitive, remember? Then learn how to use avoir l'air in French and the subtle difference between partir and sortir. And at the end, I will tell you more about the subjunctive after il faut. It's very easy to access those lessons. Just click here on your screen to watch them. I will see you in the next video. Just click here and I will see you there. Allez, à tout de suite.